Respected sirs and madams, good afternoon to all. I am Srija, working as an assistant professor in the department of EC of St. Martin's Engineering College. Now I am handling a subject called EMI. So in this video, you will get a complete information about the EMI subject. So in subject, we have many topics, but I will explain about signal generators. In this video, you will get complete information about signal generators and its types. So first, what is meant by signal generator? Let's see the definition for signal generator. As we already know, signal generator, the name itself indicates, it generates signals like sinusoidal signals, square signals, triangular signals. So mainly the purpose of signal generator is it is mainly used for generating signals. So signal generator is also called as oscillator circuit because oscillator also producing same periodic signals. So here the main principle operation will be depending upon modulation process. So here we have some basic block diagram for signal generator. Just see basic block diagram for signal generator. It consists of RF oscillator, external oscillator, here we have wideband amplifier, basic block diagram for signal generator. Here we have RF oscillator, external oscillator, wideband amplifier, next one modulator amplifier, output attenuator. Just see one by one each description. Here we have RF oscillator. The main purpose of RF oscillator is it generates carrier signal. As I already mentioned, signal generator uses modulation principle. So modulation in the sense we need two signals, one is carrier signal and second one is message signal. Here RF oscillator generates carrier signal. Next, external oscillator is used for generating message signal. So finally we are getting two signals here. So again, carrier signal will be amplified by using wideband amplifier. So wideband amplifier nothing but it is a type of amplifier which amplifies the signal. Okay, here we will get amplified version of the carrier signal. So here carrier signal and message signal both are given as input to modulator amplifier. So modulator amplifier means which uses modulation process, that means it combines carrier signal as well as message signal. So we will get modulated signal. So internally it consists of amplifier also. So this modulated signal will be amplified and then generated as an output. So finally here we are getting either AM or FM output. Okay, after modulation we will get modulated output, that is either in the form of AM amplitude modulation or frequency modulation. Okay, finally we are getting modulated output. So if this modulated output consists of high power values or high voltage values, means it will optimize that levels by using attenuator. Okay, finally we are getting modulated output. Modulated output, that is either in the form of AM or FM. So main purpose of signal generator is it generates signals like sinusoidal or square. So in this basic signal generator block diagram, we are getting sinusoidal signal as an output, that is either in the form of AM or FM. So here we have many types of signal generators. Just see the types of signal generator names. First one, AF signal generator. Second one, RF signal generator. Third one, function generator. Fourth one, sweep frequency generator. Fifth one, arbitrary waveform generator. Arbitrary waveform generator. And next, six different types of signal generators. First one, wave signal generator. Second one, RF signal generator. Third one, function generator. Fourth one, sweep frequency generator. Fifth one, arbitrary waveform generator. Sixth one, video signal generator. Let's see, first one, wave signal generator, briefly. So first, wave signal generator. First time. Wave signal generator. So AF in the sense audio frequency range. So this signal generator produces signals having audio frequency range. So the main purpose of AF signal generator is it is mainly used for generating sine and square signals. So the main purpose of signal generator, wave signal generator, is it generates sine and square signals having audio frequency range. Okay, let's see the block diagram of AF signal generator. So it mainly consists of main bridge oscillator, AF signal generator consists of blocks. First block like main bridge oscillator. Second block we have sine wave amplifier. Followed by output attenuator. Next we have square wave shaper. First one, wean bridge oscillator. Second one, sine wave amplifier. Next one, square wave amplifier, square wave shaper, output attenuator. And next we have the outputs. So this is the block diagram. Here we are connecting this wean bridge oscillator to two parts. This is the first part and second part. So wean bridge oscillator is connected to two parts by using this switch. Okay, here we have switch that connects wean bridge oscillator to two parts. Okay, so just see the description of this block diagram. So we already know about wean bridge oscillator. It is mainly used for getting sinusoidal signals. So here we are getting sine as an output. So this sinusoidal signal is given to two parts. So this is the first part and second part. So from first part we are getting sine wave as an output. From second part we are getting square wave as an output. Just see the process for getting outputs. Okay, so this sinusoidal signal is connected to first part by using a switch. Okay, if switch is connected to first part, means here sine is applied as an input to sine wave amplifier. So what is the purpose of amplifier? It improves the strength of the sinusoidal signal. Finally, we are getting amplified version of the sinusoidal signal. So this amplified version of sinusoidal signal is given to output attenuator. So the main purpose of attenuator is it limits high power values or high voltage values. Finally, we are getting sine wave as an output. So from this sine AF signal generator, we are getting first signal as sinusoidal signal. So next, if switch is connected to second path, means sinusoidal signal is applied as an input to second path. Okay, here we are applying sine as an input to square wave shaper. As we already know about square wave shaper, here square wave shaper is nothing but Schmitt Rigger circuit. So the main purpose of Schmitt Rigger circuit is it converts sinusoidal signals to square signals. So finally we are getting here square signal as an output. This square signal is applied as an input to amplifier block. So the purpose of amplifier is it improves the strength of the square signal. So finally we are getting amplified version of the square signal. So this amplified version of square signal is given to attenuator block. So the main purpose of attenuator is it limits high power values or high voltage values and sends signal to output side. So finally we are getting square wave as an output. So this is the process for getting sine and square having audio frequency range. So this is about AF signal generator. Next, see RF signal generator. So second type we have RF signal generator. So the main purpose of RF signal generator, RF means radio frequency. The second type we have RF signal generator. So the main purpose of RF signal generator is it generates the signals having radio frequency range. Okay, so here the main purpose of RF signal generator is it generates sinusoidal signals. In AF signal generator we are getting two types of signals, sine and square, but in RF we are getting only one signal, that is sinusoidal signal having radio frequency range. Okay, so just see the block diagram of RF signal generator. It consists of first block RF oscillator, second block we have external oscillator, so these both blocks are connected to modulator oscillator. Here we have output attenuator. Finally we are getting sine as an output. So this is the block diagram for RF signal generator. Here we have RF oscillator, second one external oscillator, third one modulator oscillator, fourth one output attenuator, followed by output. So the main purpose of RF signal generator is it generates signals having a radio frequency range. As we already know about RF, RF means very high frequency range signals. Okay, AF means low frequency range signals. So for getting radio frequency range signals, here we are using a process called modulation. So again, for modulation we need two signals, one is carrier signal, second one is message signal. So carrier signal is generated by using RF oscillator. Here message signal will be generated by using external oscillator. So this both carrier and message signals both are combined by using a process called modulation. So that process will be done in this block. So modulator oscillator means it combines both carrier and message signal and generates modulated waveform as an output. So here we are getting modulated output. Modulated in the sense we have two types of modulation, that means either AM or FM. So as per application we can use either AM or FM. Finally we are getting AM or FM modulated output. This modulated output is given as input to output attenuator. Again the purpose of attenuator is it limits high power values or high voltage values. Finally we are getting modulated output, that is very high frequency range, nothing but radio frequency range output. So the purpose of RF signal generator is it generates sinusoidal signal in the form of modulated output. Either AM or FM will be generated as an output. Okay, so this is about types of signal generators. So next we have many more types like a function generator, sweep frequency. We will see the two types of generators in the next video. Thank you all. Thank you.